Previously, Kes's great-grandmother fed the group a hearty breakfast, and Nova gave Saad his old staff before the group headed out to pick up the explosives they'd ordered. Upon gathering them, Isaac stored a metric shit-ton of very dangerous materials in the magical tattoo on his chest. Magic. It's fucking weird, huh? Before they left the city, Indra specifically told Nova to make sure they all came back alive. Adria used Scrying to look in on the teleportation circle on the island, and she quickly noticed that it had been interrupted. Nova looked in on the office of the council member who'd killed August, and while he was watching, he saw the man, who was clearly an illithid, eat the brain of his secretary. Since the teleportation circle was off the table, Adria transported the group to the island via tree instead. Then she and August transformed into cats and snuck into the city to pick up the maps they'd previously made arrangements to get from Ramir. Meanwhile, back in the woods where the rest of the group were gathered, Orcus the doll suddenly appeared inside a box of dynamite. Kes was overjoyed to see them and immediately began filling them in on what they'd missed, as pretty much everyone else questioned Kes's sanity yet again. Adria and August eventually arrived back in the woods and rejoined the others, and all of them discussed just what entrance they were going to take to get into the mines. They settled in to take a short rest so that Adria could get her wild shades back for the purpose of scouting. But part of the way through the rest, Zerakir heard the sound of people headed their way. He and August slipped into the forest, where they quickly saw that there were two guards from the city patrolling. The two of them decided to trail the guards for a bit so that they could make some sounds in the opposite direction if they got too close to the group. They eventually got too close for comfort, and Zerakir released a badger from his bag of tricks, which did get the attention of one of the guards, especially when he kicked said badger, only for it to disappear. Zerakir immediately cast silence around the guard, who had instantly realized something was wrong. Zerakir sent a message via the group's psychic chat, letting them all know that one of the guards knew what was up, just before he and August started fighting the guard. Back where the rest of the group were, none of them had any idea what direction the other two had run off in. Adria turned into a brontosaurus to try to find the others, her head rising above the tops of the trees. The other guard noticed the fight around then and came rushing over, pulling out an iron flask and releasing an ultraloft from it, which quickly joined the fight as well. Nova turned everyone but himself invisible, including the brontosaurus. Then Kes immediately made the spell drop on them because they cast Locate Creature to figure out what direction August and Zerakir were in since no one had a clue. August went down, and Zerakir had Venator pick him up and start flying towards the others. He sent a message via the psychic group chat telling them what was happening, and Adria quickly dropped her brontosaurus form and shifted into that of a giant eagle. She grabbed Kes and started flying in August's direction, while Ren ran forward at full speed. Nova used Dimension Door to join in the fight with Zerakir. Isaac, Kes, and Ren were close enough to see the moment August went limp in Venator's claws, even though they weren't close enough to do anything about it. Adria landed beside August's body and let Kes drop down before dropping her eagle form. Isaac got within shooting range and unloaded his gun at the ultraloft, doing a fuck ton of damage and taking it down. Shush, when it comes to Isaac, these are scientific terms. One of the guards tried to teleport away, but Nova was able to counterspell it. Nova then tried to drop a fireball on the guards, but one of them counterspelled him in return. Panicking a bit, Kes pulled out the diamond they had on them and cast Revivify. The spell worked, and August's eyes flew open. A very concerned Kes told a very confused August that they wouldn't tell Indra if he didn't. Moments later, Zerakir ended the fight with the guards in a permanent kind of way. Kes immediately cast Heal on August, putting him back at full health. Around that time, the group realized just how loud they'd been during the fight, and how close to the city they were. The city where they were all very, very wanted. And that is where we left off.